Talking fishing, talking fishing, nothing but fishing, we're talking fishing.
It is that time of year where people are starting to think about their holidays, heading away on Boxing Day or thereafter, and there's so many things to pack. Yep. You want to get all the light gear in the car, you want to take all the little things you only drag out of the shed once a year, and ads, you've got a whole heap of them to show to people.
A whole heap of them. These probably double as a great little Christmas gift when we see a lot of people this time of year who are buying for partners, boyfriends, husbands, whatever.
It'd have to be the biggest time of year that females come into the shop.
Yeah, that's right. And they might not necessarily know what everyone uses, what they like. So this is just a little handy selection of things that everyone can do with. I'll start with the Frabil Net.
The what?
Well, the Frabil Net. Look at that. Right down there. That's it looks like a weapon at this point. But that's the beauty of it. It can be used as a weapon, but we won't go there. It's easy to store, and as you push it out, it turns into a net.
There you go.
They come in various sizes. This is the small one. They make a medium-sized one where their net head's just that little bit bigger, and then there's a big one, which is crazy long, big net head. But they are great for everyone.
That'd be perfect for stowing in your tinny when you haven't got a lot of room around the place.
That's why they've been so popular, because you can store them anywhere. It's as easy. It's almost like working a shotgun.
Yeah.
Pull it all in, and it all stores.
I was going to say a beach umbrella, but anyway.
Oh, or a beach umbrella, Dave, if that's the way you're more inclined. But that all stows down inside the tube, and that's ready to go. So that's just a handy little, I guess, Christmas gift for those who have got boats or don't have big places and need to store things, which is always a little bit of a problem. This is exciting, Dave. There's been a bit of a flurry. We're just talking about it before we come back to air in the last break, and there's a few of these getting about now. These are an Esky, which also double as a live bait tank. Now, this one's pretty large, so it's a bit hard to see, but your aerator mounts to the side. So it sits all on the Esky.
It's got a proper clip on it and everything.
It does,
so that sits
straight on there.
Yep.
The tube goes through the hole in the side of the Esky, which...
Can you turn that around to show for it?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to see.
No, there, you can see that all right. There's the
little hole there. Yeah. Now, as you open it up...
And your little aeration stone sits in there.
You've got your little tub, which you can put bait and bits and pieces. Now, the stone... I've just covered my face. This is really hard to see. the stone goes through and sits inside. So that's always generating bubbles, generating oxygen for your live baits. If you're not using it as a live bait Esky, there's a little plug.
Yeah.
Stick the plug in, and now you use it as your normal Esky. Yep. Fill it full of ice, put a few cans in it, a few softies, a couple of waters, and you're good to go. Mm.
Yeah.
But these are going to be a huge Christmas item.
For taking yabbies.
Yep.
Bass yabbies, if you're in the boat and you want a bit of salt water and your bass yabbies and all that sort of stuff. And it's going to keep them for days. Like, how good's that?
I reckon we'll find, as kingfish season comes into play, smaller tinnies, smaller boats which don't have the plumbed live bait tanks, which don't have a lot of space to even put one in. That doubles as your Esky. You can use it as a seat, but you can keep your live baits. Whether it's your yakkers or your slimies or any of that sort of bits and pieces, you can keep them there and you can keep them alive and you keep them fresh for your kings. They're going to be a Christmas hit, I think. Few different sizes. You mainly see the large ones about, and then as we continue through
the small
ones.
I think the smallest is either 8 or 12 litre from memory, which, that you can throw over your shoulder and walk a river if you want.
Exactly. For guys fishing the Western Lakes, Bull and Bear Eye, Parambit, where you've got your gudgeon and your bullhead, put your pots down, go for a fish, come back, keep them in that.
Yeah.
Everything's by your side and you're ready to go. Nothing beats live bait.
Guys fishing the Bowen and those areas for Mulloway with their small live salmon and mullet.
Beautiful. Mick, I'm going to throw the next one to you because this is a pretty hot Christmas gift. Dave, I'll get you to throw over the Marttiini tin. This is tailor-made for Christmas.
Yeah, these have been a really popular item every year, and they are a fantastic gift idea. In this one, you've got the tin, which presents really nicely and is easy to wrap up. There's no sharp edges on it, but inside there is a couple of sharp edges. You've got a couple of sizes of knives, one that's ideal for your snapper and your larger fish, your gummies and things like that. And then you've also got your smaller knife in here, which is ideal for your trout, your whiting, and that sort of stuff. And it's in a it's really well presented, so it's always a popular item on the Christmas list for everyone. As well as that, you've got this free lure that comes with it as well. So that's an absolutely awesome one.
Beautiful. So again, great Christmas gift, because yeah, everyone needs a good knife. Martini is as good a quality as it gets for a fisherman.
They are a fantastic blade.
So great gift idea. And Mick, while you're still on a roll, mate, the old seat backpack, the Christmas special.
This is a classic one for those ones that are, you know, getting a bit older and they need a seat when they're sitting along the riverbank there. But it's a backpack. It's got your two straps there. It's also a bag with about three or four compartments inside it here. You've got a large zip up the front area, so you can even put bait in that, easy to wash out, and then quite easily folds out to a chair with the back on it.
Just handy, and it's a great little gift thing when you got your caravan. Dave, you take the caravan down to the peninsula every year, even just for those nice balmy afternoons. You can sit on the beach, even if you've got a rod out or not, it doesn't matter.
Yep.
Take in the sunset, have a couple of drinks, and away you go.
Great gift, that one.
And this one, I think, this is probably more of a gift idea when you're not too sure what you do. This is great for the holidays. So many people holiday on Port Phillip Bay. It's crystal clear water. We get those nice, balmy, calm nights. Have a step out in the water. You only have to go up to your knees after dark. Put the old prawn light down. No, we're not actually looking for prawns, but put the prawn light down. Have a hand spear on you. Single prong hand spear, so she's all legal. Flathead, squid, flounder, the whole kit and caboodle. You'll be absolutely amazed at what you can see of a nighttime.
Crabs,
starfish. The bay, bay comes alive. It does.
Yeah, so, and quite often 1 to 2 feet
exactly.
of water.
Exactly. You only have to go to your knees.
Yeah.
Shine that light and watch the fish come to you. It's one of those great activities for the kids, those warm, balmy nights when it's a bit too warm, no air conditioning in the caravan. Go for a walk. I think it's one of those things. You'll be very surprised and might actually inspire you to take a fishing rod one night and have a blind flick because there's some good fish around and not much water.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. So plenty for people to think about, and you'll get all of those things in any good tackle shop. Just go and check them out.
Talking fishing, nothing but fishing, talking fishing. If it's facts about fishing that you want to know, then tune in, folks, because this is the show. We'll show